Hi, good people. How are you? As for me, I'm very fine, but hey, it's cold. It's very cold. It's very, very cold. All right, so today we are continuing. We are looking at ions and ionic bond. How do ions form? That's the first thing, right? So we say that an atom is most stable when the valence electron shell is completely filled. So every atom of an element fights to have a complete outer shell that is completely filled. If it's in period one, it would prefer to be filled with two electrons, and then others 8, 8, 18, and so forth, going up all the way. So atoms of elements, well, so what do? They either gain or lose electrons for them to attain a stable electronic configuration or a noble configuration, right? So nonmetals, usually they gain electrons to form negative ions, and these negative ions we call them anions, right? But as for metals, most of them they tend to donate electrons. As they donate electrons, they form what we call positive ions, and these positive ions are called cations, right? So the charge of an ion can be found by finding the difference between the number of electrons and the proton numbers, right? So we should also be able to draw dot and cross diagrams to describe the formation of ionic bonds between group one and group four. That takes place between positively charged ion. We call it ionic bonding. So a compound that is formed from a positively charged ion and a negatively charged ion, we call it an ionic compound. So ionic compounds are formed when there's a transfer of electrons, right? Electrons are transferred or they are donated by the metal to the nonmetal. Remember, we say that the one that is donating is going to have a positive charge. The one that is receiving is going to have a negative charge. So in this example, we are focusing on the reaction between group 1 elements and group 7 elements. Group 1 elements are very special. They are all metals, and group 7 elements are halogens, which are colorful gases, right? So now we are saying the transfer of electrons, it forms anions and cations. If you are the one who's receiving electrons, you form anions. The one donating ions become donating electrons becomes the cations, right? So in this type of bonding, ions are arranged in an ionic lattice and are held together by strong electrostatic forces of attraction. So an example of a dot and cross diagram, we have it here where we are reacting our sodium metal with chlorine gas to form sodium chloride. So sodium, like we spoke of sodium on our previous video, it has got 11 electrons with one electron in the outer shell. Remember, every electron is fighting to have a full octet shell. So sodium, what's going to happen? It's going to donate its one electron to chlorine. And the good thing the chlorine is with chlorine is that it has got 7 electrons in the outer shell. It only needs one to have 8. So sodium donates that one electron, it goes to chlorine. So at the end of the day, your sodium ion now it's having a plus charge because it lost one electron. Chlorine, it's having a negative ion because it has gained one electron, right? So now the name, now it's a reaction between sodium and chlorine. But the compound that is formed, we call it sodium chloride. The chlorine changed the surname from in to ide. Chlorine, chloride. Sodium, chloride. So sodium did not change anything. It's sodium chloride. Take note of that, right? We also need to describe the formation of ionic bonds between metallic and non-metallic elements. To include also the strong attraction between ions because of their opposite electrical charges. You know, unlike atoms, they attract very strong. So now we are saying ionic bonding should be defined as guided by the following steps. The first step we are saying metal atoms lose electrons to form cations. That's a very important point. The electrons lost. Oh, I really apologize, guys. I'm recording with my son, right? So we are saying the electrons lost by metal ions are gained by non-metallic atoms to form anions. The oppositely charged ions are held together by very strong electrostatic forces of attraction acting between these ions because of their opposite electrical charges. So we have a very strong force of attraction between the two. The reason being, unlike charges, they attract. There is a strong bond that is being formed, right? The attraction described in three are ionic bonds, right? Another important thing is that we need to take note of is that an ionic bond can only occur between metals and nonmetals only. Are we together? And then the next thing that we need to have a look at is we should be able to describe the lattice structure of ionic compounds as a regular arrangement of alternating positive and negative ions. We have an example of sodium chloride. The lattice structure will look like something like this. Our chloride ions are these ones, the black ones. And then the sodium ions are those tiny ones, the clear small circles. So we are saying here, ionic substances appear as giant lattice structures with a regular arrangement of alternating positive and negative ions. That's a very important note to consider. So that's it on ionic bonds, ionic compounds. And then on our next video, I'm going to be explaining molecules and covalent bonding.